everyone, welcome. My name is Gaby Sparts and I'm a Magic the Gathering player and streamer, and I'm here with a quick crash course on how to use Magic Online. So the first thing you want to do is actually download the client. The way you do that is open a new browser window, use Google, and search for Download Magic Online. The first thing that shows up is Download Magic Online Wizards of the Coast. I will link to all these in the description of this video, but if you search for any of these, they're usually going to be the first result. So Download Magic Online. And remember, Magic Online only works for Windows, so that's something to keep in mind. So here I would download now, and it saves a program onto my computer. I already have a copy of Magic Online, but here I would just run it, I would open it, and then I would hit this, and it will start the program for me. So it's gonna look something like this. Welcome to Magic Online. The next thing I need is a Magic Online account. So in order to get that, I would once again open a new browser window and search for sign up for Magic Online. So the first thing that shows up is the Magic Online new account creation, and that is a link that I want to click. Cool. So it's going to ask me for some information before I can sign up. First is my birthday, so I'm going to choose September 1st of 1987. Somewhere here. It's gonna ask me how much Magic the Gathering I've played. So I've played lots. And it's gonna ask me for some more information before I can sign up. So my email is gonna be gaby@dose.com. My username is gonna be legacattack. Oh, I already signed this up. Legacattack, there you go. I'm gonna choose a new password. Oops. And my security question is going to be, who teach you how to play Magic? And I'm going to say, my dog. That is not true. My dog did not teach me how to play Magic. Okay. Now it's going to ask for my billing address. And so obviously this is sensitive information, so I will be right back while I sign us up. So you'll fill out all the information and you will buy your new Magic Online account. Your Magic Online account costs $10 and it comes with a new player pack. The new player pack includes 5 event tickets, 20 new player points, 650 cards to get your collection started, and some avatars. Then you're gonna get an email from Wizards for you to confirm your account. So that email looks something like this. This is me buying my account and here it is confirmed. And then I'll get an email and I'll click a link that it gives me and it'll populate here automatically. My username and the activation code for my account. So I'm gonna continue. And it says, thank you for joining Magic Online. Now you can download the program. So if you've already downloaded the program, you don't need to do this. If you haven't downloaded, go ahead and do it now. And now our account is activated. So let's take it back to Magic Online. All right. Hello, welcome back. So we are not gonna be in my Gaby Sparts account. We are in the Legac Attacks account, and let's join real quick. Cool. So when you sign up for a brand new account, this is the screen that's going to show up. I am eligible to receive prizes. Make sure you read this. Okay. I do want to receive rewards, and I don't really want to list into the opt to the mailing list in because I'm already signed up, but if you want here, you can check okay and proceed. So this is your home base. Whenever you go to Magic Online, this is what it's going to look like. Let me take my camera off real quick so you guys can see this better. So here are announcements. Anything about new tournaments that are coming up, changes to pre-releases, anything like that. Be sure to just check out these announcements because they'll keep you up to date. Here is your buddies section. So buddies are people that you're friends with that are playing Magic Online currently. So, you know, if I added myself and my other account, I can see me. And this red dash means that I'm not currently online. But if I add another one of my friends, look, my friend is currently online. That's the red button there. And from here, you can do a couple of things. You can trade with them. You can challenge them. You can direct message them as well. A list of upcoming tournaments, though I have no settings picked, so nothing's going to show up here right now. And also leagues. And we'll talk about leagues in a little bit. So first, let's go to the collection section. All right. In the collection section is where we can see all of our cards and where we can build all of our decks. So currently there's nothing here because this is a brand new account. Here, I'm gonna come back. And this is not excellent because we need to build some decks. So let's go to other products. So the things that show up in other products are things like play points, QPs, any sets that you may have purchased, anything you buy from the store as well. A lot of times it'll end up in the other product section. So here we have the new account product. We're gonna go ahead and open this. So I'm gonna open one of them. Are you sure you want to open one of these? Yes, open one. Cool, and this is a new player starter kit that I was talking about a bit ago. Here you can maximize it, and we can take a look at everything here. We have five avatars. The avatar that you play with is what shows up when you play against an opponent. It's the username, it's like the picture that shows up for you. And then 650 cards just to kind of get our collection going. So I am gonna go ahead and close this. Here are the 20 new player points. New player points are great. They will let you play in events. It's the way you enter any sort of event. And specifically for new player points, these are great because if you're just getting used to the client and you're not sure how exactly everything functions, you know, joining a new player event is a very easy way for you to get some practice and get better at it. Event tickets are the way you join other queues as well. And these will be not for new players, but for everybody in Magic Online at large. So here in this view, you can build deck lists. I'm gonna take my camera off so you guys can see all the cards. All right, so here you can sort things by colors. So we can see all of our white cards. Or we can see all of our blue cards. If we wanted to see our hybrid cards, we could click these two together and we see things like Thunderclap, which is a blue-white card. Anything like this removes the filters and then we can continue to look for things. So if we wanted to search for something specifically, let's say we wanted to build a deck with something like Leaf Gilder, we can search for something like that. This number here indicates how many of this card you have in your collection. So currently we have 3. If we wanted to start a new deck, the way we would do that is go down here into this button over here that says add new deck to your collection. So let's go ahead and do that. It's going to give us 2 options for how to import a deck list. The first one's the import option and the next one is the create a deck. For the import option, this is very useful. The way you do it is you create a text file that has a deck list like this. Here on the left is the number of cards that you want, and then on the right is the name of the card. And then the space makes the difference between main deck and sideboard. So if I were to import this text file like this, it would populate this specific deck list onto Magic Online. For this one, we're just going to create a new deck list. So this is going to call the Green Stompy. I'm going to choose this forest, say okay. This is where you build your decks. Currently, Green Stompy has 0 cards in the main decks, 0 in the sideboard. So if we just wanted to take a look at all of the green cards that we had, we could start building this deck, for example, not red, green. If you click a card, it'll populate it in the main deck. You can also drag it down. And you can do the same for the sideboard. So if I want to add some of these plummets to my sideboard, I would add them like this. If you ever add a card that's not in your collection, it'll look something like this. Little error shows up here, and an error shows up here as well. It'll tell you what's wrong. Our deck is too small, so obviously we need 60 main deck cards, 15 sideboard, and some cards are not in my collection, so in this case, this one's not in the collection. This means that you can still build a deck even if you don't have the cards, though it will not let you register this deck for an actual tournament. And then your deck is going to show up here, and then your different formats will also show up here. So currently we only have a standard deck, but if we had built a modern deck, a new modern option would have shown up here. Now let's take a look at the play lobby. The play lobby is where you play any game of Magic. That is true for constructed, limited, or open play. So constructed tournaments has 3 options: queues, scheduled, and leagues. Queues are for if you want to join an 8-man, if you want to join a 2-man, for example, here would be like a Legacy pickup game, standard pickup game, and a single elimination 8-man queue. And this tells you how many players you still need to join. So like if we wanted to join the standard single elimination queue, we don't currently have the tickets to do so, but we would register this and we would choose which deck we want to play. And currently there is no one waiting to play this right now, so we would be the first ones in the queue. For scheduled event, you have things like daily events. And then for leagues, which are 5 rounds, you sign up and then you play. And the nice thing about leagues is you can come back and play them whenever you want. So The other queues you have to play, you know, 8 rounds or 3 rounds of Swiss. Whereas for leagues, you can just play a game, you can play a match and just be done and come back to it whenever you want. Leagues is actually my favorite way to play Magic Online, so highly recommend it if you haven't checked it out. For limited tournaments, we have basically the same options. We have queues, and these are the limited formats that you currently can't play, so we can play with the Gatewatch, Magic Origins, there's some flashback drafts such as Ravnica, Guild Pact, or Dragons of Tarkir. For scheduled, we would have some of those daily events. There's currently nothing scheduled right now. And for leagues, we could do a league of sealed. And here's how you would join that. And then lastly, we have constructed open play. Constructed tournaments and limited tournaments require tickets for you to join them. Constructed open play means that you can just play against anybody at any time. You don't need any tickets to do so. So just starting out is like that. Exactly what it seems. It's a room full of people who are still getting used to the client and are maybe newer to Magic or maybe newer to Magic Online. So depending on the level of difficulty you want, you can actually change these up. Tournament practice being the most serious one. Here you would choose the deck you want to play with. We would choose Green Stompy in this case, but obviously this deck is currently not legal. It doesn't have all the cards that we need, so it's not going to let us choose it. And then you can also take a look at who's currently hosting games. So it looks like Night Skies is hosting a modern game and Kenki is hosting a standard game. And you can host one too, and then somebody will join if they want to battle you. Taking a look at the store is where you can buy tickets. So tickets will allow you to enter different queues. You can buy other things such as packs, lands, event tickets, anything you want. Pretty much you can get it here. All of these things will end up in your other products, so just that's something to remember. Let's take a look at the trade view. Trade is how you can get cards of Magic Online when you are looking to build different decks. So the way trade works is you have different people, users on Magic Online, and also some bots. And you can buy and sell cards from them. So we were looking for something specific, like let's say we wanted to buy Llanowar Wastes. Here we can see everybody on Magic Online that has Llanowar Wastes, either buying or selling them. And remember, if you want to initiate a trade with somebody on Magic Online, you have to make sure that your event tickets are in your active trade binder. So the way you do that is you right-click your event tickets and you add them to trade binder. You can add all of them to your trade binder if you want. And now that you go trade with people, you'll make sure that you have those tickets available for trade when you are in the middle of a trade with them. The last thing to look at is the account section. These are all settings that are up to you. You can have foil treatment on your card, summoning sickness, the volume settings. These are just up to your choice. Lastly, we have the help section. The help section has answers to pretty much anything you might want, but most importantly, you can chat with support. So if you ever run into any issues, you find bugs, you want to do anything like that, you can just talk to somebody from the Magic Online team and they'll help you out with any questions that you might have. So I hope this was helpful, everybody. It's a very quick crash course in Magic Online, but it's enough to get you started. If you have any other questions, I would love to hear them. I'm Gaby Sparts on Twitter and on Twitch. As you know, I stream Magic Online there too. And now it's time for you to download the client and go try it out for yourself. So good luck, have fun, everybody.